it's always a great pleasure at an institution like this to have special events where we can get together and celebrate each other. And this one is particularly pleasing because it gives us an opportunity to celebrate our history, and celebrate our history in a way that we haven't at this institution before. We've got a very strong bond amongst people at this institution, a very strong bond amongst people who worked here, who went to school here, and this gives us an opportunity to actually get something up in a public place where we can walk through it, we can touch it, we can feel it, and we can really recognize and celebrate the strength of this institution. One of the things that I firmly believe in is you can't move forward as an institution with strength without recognizing and celebrating what you've done in the past. Because the only reason that we have an opportunity to move forward with what we're doing as an institution is because we've had such dedicated people here before that have helped shape and put the framework in place for us to move forward. And so while we may change, or we may change a name, or we may move forward with different programs and different activities and do things a little bit differently, we can only do that. We can only do that evolution. We can only do that change, and we can only do that building because we've got such a strong base in that history that we've had before us. And so that to me is important for us to always take the time to take a look back and say thank you by publicly recognizing it and having it in a public place. And so when I bring my kids here, I can walk up and have them walk through. When I bring my parents here, I can have them walk through. And every alumni can do that. Every one of you who are retirees can do that, because we've got it now in a public place where we can celebrate it. Every student that comes and participates at this institution, when they get an orientation, their orientation is going to walk them by the history wall, so that they understand that this place had a number of other names. And you know, there's always a bit of confusion. Was Malaspina 40 years old? Yes, it was. But we also had 35 other years of post-secondary education in the city, and started with Jack McCready. Jack McCready in 1936 with his first trades programs that happened here down on Campbell and McCleary Streets. And the fact is that building is still there. It's now a judo club. It's down in that gyro park. And we're working with the city. We're going to get some plaques put on it in the 75th year. Also, the old hospital. Many of you worked in the old hospital that are here. We're going to be getting a plaque put on that hospital. But when you walk in that door, you're going to see this was Malaspina College at one time, and a whole celebration in history there. And it's extremely important that we do that, because those are place markers. Those are place statements. They're place definitions of where this institution has come from and where it's going. And we're adding 5 new buildings next year, if you can believe it. Just think of McCready in his head back in 36 when he was working in a garage. Did he think in any one given year there'd be 5 new buildings, let alone this whole hillside filled with buildings, let alone this incredible place down in Cowichan, what's happening in Powell River, what's happening in Parksville, all the other things that are happening? I'm sure he wasn't thinking that way. And people are going to look back at us from 60 years, 50 years from now, and this institution is going to be here, but it's going to have more buildings, it's going to have different emphases, it's going to have a lot of different things. But we're making history all the time as well. And as we make that history, if we don't have a respect for our history, then we're not going to have the kind of investments and the recognition and doing things in the way that are important to build on. So during 2011, we're going to have a variety of events that take place on all campuses, including a whole number of events throughout the year. There's going to be block parties in each community that we're going to have to celebrate the 75th. We've already started talking about those and planning those. We've got the opening of the 5 new facilities that I mentioned, and we're going to make sure that those are part of the celebration of the 75th, and make sure that those are designated as such as part of that celebration. Next October is when we're planning a grand celebration. So October 2011 is when we're going to have some big festival celebration, as well as the block parties. So what I want to do is start this celebration by saying thank you. I want to thank you for all of your efforts in being part of this history. You're the ones that created the history. You know, I've been here 3 years, been a part of a little bit of the history, but 3 years of 75 is a small portion. Some of you spent your careers here. There's an incredible amount of contributions. We look forward to the continued contribution. What we're going to do now, I think, is move over and think about getting into a situation where we can cut the ribbon on this wall.
Make the big cut there.
Chop, chop.
Hey. There you go.
Very good. Thank you.
All right.